Hello, Dr. Urban here. I'm coming to talk to you today about a common pedestrian supplement that has excited me so much. I was going to give this information to my family, and then maybe I thought, well, maybe I'll send it to my larger circle of friends, and I decided I'm just going to put a video out on it. It was a surprise. As you know from a previous video, I'm a big fan of taking supplements for cold and flu prevention. But it works through your immune system. I want a robust immune system so when the bugs come at me, that is the microbes and the viruses and whatevers, I have a strong immune system and that is my defense. It's not that they're not going to come and it's not that they're not going to take you on. It's going to be that you ward them off. That's just how I look at it. Well, let's get back to vitamin D, which along with vitamin C, NAC, N-acetylcysteine, and zinc, those four are from a previous video, which is lined up to come next in the playlist. Just stay on the line. Those four supplements are my immune buildup supplement package. Well, okay, let's take vitamin D. Vitamin D, I had been kind of, whenever I get like a cough or a stuffy nose or something like that, I immediately go to my, not on the maintenance dose, but as in the next video, I up my schedule of these four supplements. And nothing I say here changes that. But all of a sudden, I'm looking at a video on YouTube out of the blue that talks about cathelicidins, which are peptides. That's just a kind of a scientific word. I don't know if I'd recognize a peptide if I saw one, but they're around. And these cathelicidins are your own antibiotics. You make antibiotics and antiviral, like antibiotics, and they can peel off the protective layers of viruses and kill the virus. And you make them. You may have a thousand of them or several thousand. They're finding more and more, and they're called cathelicidin. Isn't that wonderful? You make your own antibiotics. Well, I was so excited because I like vitamin D. I've taken it for years. So now I have a deeper dive into the information about vitamin D. So, but don't change your healthcare regimen because of anything you hear here. Don't stop anything or start anything without consulting your healthcare provider. That's only common sense. But consider that vitamin D is now, in my opinion, strongly substantiated to be an anti microbial, your homemade antimicrobial producer, because it upregulates it. That's the word. I was searching for the word. Upregulates means you get more of those personal antibiotics. I'm probably not giving you a scientific explanation, but boy, is this significant to me. Okay? So that's the message. Subscribe to my channel. More health videos are coming. Stay in touch. And we'll pursue these subjects together. I'm excited about vitamin D. And even though I've taken it for years, now I feel confident I would not hesitate to take up to a lot, like 50,000 doses, 50,000 international units in 2 doses in a day. Now, I haven't done it yet, but depends on what attack I perceive. Now, I just want to show you that one of these, excuse me just a minute. Yes. I don't know if you can see that, but that's 5,000 international units of vitamin D. Well, I don't know if that's a lot compared to what we've used in the past, but I take maintenance dose of 10,000 a day, 2 of these a day, and if I have 3 in my hand, I take all 3. Now that's not very scientific, and you clinicians out there can say, "What does he think he's doing?" and "How reckless can you be?" But that's where I go with this because I really like vitamin D. I did discover I had some runny nose and stuffiness, and whenever I get that, I go out and up my maintenance dose, just kind of double up or triple up, depending on how long the symptoms last. And it just so happened I took some vitamin D, and I noticed it was like a response, dramatic response in a couple hours. And I'm thinking, well, that's probably something I need to learn. So I think vitamin D is a big deal. So think about taking your supplements. I'm not telling you to take the flu shot, yes or no, or anything else. You can decide for yourself. I'm not telling you whether I take the flu shot, yes or no. There are other issues, like maybe you have to. But I don't have to. So anyway, that's it for this video. Subscribe, come along. Hopefully we'll have a fun journey learning things.